Yo guys, what is up? This is Nick, and we are back on The Witcher 3 getting chased by sirens in our boat. We're about to get our ship fucked up. This is kinda... it's working out well, though. They keep attacking the same side of the boat, so... you know, my boat's not gonna ever go... oh my god, there's a hole in the side. No, fuck you, siren! Oh shit. Oh shit. No. Go! Go! Oh shit. Fuck you, sirens. Fuck you. This is why no one likes you! Being like shit. My boat taking on water yet? Oh my god. Fuck you, siren. You little shit. Don't do it. Don't do it. Holy shit, they're everywhere. They're fucking everywhere. Oh shit! Go, go, go. These sirens are creepy looking as all hell. What is the siren doing? Is it ever gonna disengage, or are we just, it's just riding with us? It's going to the island with us. No, no, that's not what I wanted. This siren, what is the siren doing? This has got to be the island of mist right up here. What is this siren do? Siren? Siren, we about to have a problem here. Get off of my boat so I can select travel to the Isle of Mist. Yeah, fuck you, siren. We're hella close now. 300 to go. We got those sirens in the background now. They weren't enough. They couldn't handle it. They couldn't handle the truth. Alright. Well, we're almost here. Now, where do I need to land? So we need to go... okay, we need to go around this. Head around this way. Head around town. Heading around town. Alright. New quest, the Lord of Undvik. Explore the ruins of Urshkar and search for signs of Hjalmar's present using your Witcher sense. Alright. It'll mist. So I think this is where we need to be. Alright, Siri. I'm coming to get you. Warning, save your game now. You're nearing a crucial point in the game story is recommended. Okay. I'll save my game. After traveling to the Isle of Mist, some side quests will no longer be available. Recommended character level 22 or higher. That's fine.
The curse that held Uma proved hard to lift, but Yennefer and the Witchers managed to do it. The ugliest man alive revealed himself to be not man, but elf, and an elven sage at that. Avalach, for this was his name, was the elven mage who had helped Ciri flee the hunt, then hidden her away on the Isle of Mists.
Ciri, where are you? Follow the firefly. Can't see the firefly, that stupid sail gets in the way. Where are you going, firefly? Can't this firefly just fly in a straight motion? Oh, you can see it through the sail. Good job! Good job, CD Projekt Rekt or whatever, whoever made this game. Oh, we're just running into shit. No! Get back on! Take the helm. Reverse this shit. Kick that bitch into reverse. Kick the bitch into reverse. Firefly! Help me! Oh shit. We're taking more damage here. Firefly, where are we going? Oh god. Get away from me! Get away from me! Leave me alone! Oh my god, this dude's on my ass. Make that sharp left turn. Ah. I see, Firefly. Oh shit! Oh shit. Let's go! Let's go, Geralt! Oh, you're about to get jumped. Oh, you just got your shit jumped. Oh shit. What did... Here we go. Oh, get off the boat! Get off the boat! Come on, Geralt! A tall ass. I think we got away from him. I think we're good. Oh shit! What the? I need to get to level 20 at least here. Yes, it's recommended level 22, but I'm on the easiest difficulty, so 20 will have to do. On my harder difficulty, I probably have to aim for like level 29 or something crazy like that. I don't know if I'm gonna do my Death March playthrough like 3 episodes a day.
I'll look inside.
I don't know if I'll do those three episodes. I don't know if I'll be playing it as much as I've been playing my first playthrough.
Anybody in there?
Damn.
Ciri.
I'm not gonna hurt you. Open up.
Oh, you blew a fucking cupboard. Who are you? What do you want?
I'm Geralt, a witcher.
Oh, go away!
Looking for a young woman, ashen hair, scar on her face. Will you let me in?
No.
Running short on patience.
Wonderful. Means you're about to go the fuck away. By my mum's beard, get yourselves together, lads. You there, outside the door. Geralt, the right.
Yeah, Geralt.
Listen, Geralt, let's cut to the thick of it. We survived a shipwreck recently. Beasts from the depths ate some of my lads, and the rest of us found shelter here. Not too special, that, as dangers litter this isle, but it does go to explain why we're a wee bit distrustful.
Got nothing to fear from me,
said the fox to the gaggling geese.
I had lost too many mates already. I won't risk it. I can't.
Open the door, or I'll open it myself.
You try. These hinges, this lock, they'll withstand anything. Of course, you could always come back with a platoon of engineers, a battering ram, and a hackerman locksmith. Why the threats? We's only one cart. We'd do better to help each other than argue.
All right. What do you want?
I want you to find our mates. Ivo, Ferenc, and Gaspard. They ventured off, but they're on the isle missing, and probably lost. Help them. Help me. Please. If anyone can find them, I know you can.
This Ivo, where do I look?
Edgert insisted he'd explore the caves to the east. Tried to knock it out his head, literally. Bugger wouldn't budge.
Gaspard, where'll I find him?
He said it was defeatist to sit and wait to be rescued. We had to take action, or at least he did. Claimed to have spotted a lantern out to sea, so he said he'd climb the highest peak to look out for ships.
Where'd Ferenc go?
West, in search of a ship that's said to be out there.
Ferenc is handy. Thought I might fix it up. You see what the...
All right. See if I can't find all three. See ya.
I'm content you understand.
Why am I always... What?
Come on.
Why does everybody have to... They want you to do shit. They can't just do something on their own. Oh, shit. Hold on. Put on Gwen. Come on. No, I fucking have the wrong spell on. Damn it. Where's the stupid cave this dude went in? I mean, I'm trying to run away from harpies right now. You gotta be kidding me, Geralt, with that fall. I can't. Oh my god. Fuck you. Where? Oh, you have got to be kidding me.
A man! Am I ever pleased to see you?
I talked to your friends. Come down.
Right. I'm coming.
You lucky devil, you.
You know, I've one regret that.
You dumbass.
Dead. Damn.
I'm a fucking idiot. Alright! Look for Gaspard near the lighthouse. Alright, Gaspard. Alright, Gaspard, where are you? Can I climb this thing? Can I scale this thing like a champ? Oh shit! I forgot Geralt's legs are like jello. He can't fucking take damage of any sort. Should probably stop collecting stuff like that, but I don't know, I like to see what I'm collecting. And I can that way. Okay, so he's not up here. Where the hell is this dude at? He can't be down. He's gotta be somewhere around here. Where the hell is this bitch? It says near the lighthouse, not in the lighthouse, which makes me think... the confusion. When the confusion sets in. There he is.
Fetlock.
I missed the ladder.
Hey, wake up.
Shoo. Back to bed, Nibbles.
Wake up.
What's happening? Who are you?
I'm Geralt. Your friends asked me to find you, Ferenc, and Ivo.
I'm afeard they're dead. Some horror swarmed Ivo, saw it with my own eyes. And Ferenc, I heard him. A blood-curdling cry, then the roar of a beast.
Let's get back to the hut. I'll protect you along the way.
Shame about the lads, really, but what can you do? Come on. But I should warn you, I suffer from narcolepsy, meaning...
I know what it means. Don't worry, I'll keep you awake.
Off we go then.
Come on, you idiot. All right, fuck you. I'll just leave you then. What is he doing? Are you serious? I'm gonna have to walk with him? Oh no, he's hiding like a little bitch. Thank you for finally. Oh shit! Let's go, you dumb shit. Come on!
If you're a wee bit drowsy. Oh.
Wake up.
I'm awake. Wide awake.
Come on, keep moving.
Are you gonna get up? Oh my god, dude, this is fucking stupid.
No, who the hell? This aisle.
Almost nothing.
You know, it ain't on my map.
A common characteristic of enchanted islands.
Hello? Sick of their shit. I'm gonna have to go wake him up again. Come on, you stupid bitch. Dude, I didn't like dwarfs before, now I really don't like them in this game. Like, the hell? Come on. How do I get back up here? The aisle, okay. That's where I need to go. This doesn't seem right. You
stronger than me, I'm so.
Wake up.
Right, just a wee bit longer.
Get up.
Drifting off. I'll soon.
This is fucking so egregiously stupid that I have to keep waking this stupid guy up. This literally ruins this mission.
Wake up.
I'm awake. Wide awake.
Come on, keep moving.
Oh my god, dude. Whoever decided, let's make a guy who... Dude, it's just... Oh my god. I don't know how to get up here. to this stupid thing. I hate when games do this. You gotta follow that. Okay. Come on, motherfucker. Come on, you stupid piece of shit. Come on! You dumb motherfucker. This is the same shit with that stupid-ass goat mission. Is he fucking coming? Dude, let's go! Alright, where the fuck is this path that it's showing on my mini-map? Alright, now look. There's a... The path is up there. Like, how the hell do I get back up there? Here we go. Watch, I'm gonna get up here. And it's gonna be like, oh, you gotta wake him up, because this motherfucker can't go 10 seconds without falling the fuck asleep. Are you gonna come bite me, Harpy? Or he's gonna be a little bitch. Had enough of your shit, Harpy. Dude, look at how many harpies there are. I guarantee you, it's gonna say, oh, you gotta go wake his bitch ass up. Why is my fist out? What is this? Why are my fists out? Draw your damn sword! I'm gonna fucking die because Geralt's bitch ass and that. Oh my god, and I have. Oh my fucking shit, dude. Are you fucking kidding me? Now I gotta do that all over again. This is the fucking most annoying episode ever. Because Geralt's fucking legs are like fucking jello. I jumped off like... Alright, it was like 6 feet. And he took all damage. Like, it's ridiculous. Like, whoever designed that is fucking stupid. Like, this isn't a realistic game to begin with. Why are you making realistic features like that? And honestly, I can make a 6 foot jump. And obviously, you know... We're all the way back here at the fucking beginning. Because why would it go any other way? Can you tell that this pisses me off? Where is the other stupid fucking bitch that... I don't care about these level zeros. Where the hell is the main guy? There he is. Come here, you stupid dumbass. I have to wake this stupid fuck up when he gets down here. Let's go, fat ass! What the hell is he doing? Where is he? He's not what the hell? He ran inside here. What the fuck is going on? Why is my sword drawn? There's still enemies up here?
If you're... Wee bit drowsy.
Oh. Of course you are, because you are fucking stupid. Wow, you made it like a whole
wake
five
up.
Steps. Wake your awake. Fucking
wait,
bitch
wait,
ass
wait.
Up.
Come on, keep moving.
Oh my god, dude. What in the... Like, what in the absolute fuck is going on? He gonna come? Come on, you stupid fucking faggot ass dwarf. Let's go. Oh my god, dude. This is. What the fuck is Geralt doing? Yo, this is just an episode filled with me fucking cussing about everything because it's just so fucking stupid. Why would you give a fucking character this fucking issue? It's just stupid. It's just something that was that's lazy because they couldn't find another way to make this hard. Like, that's just stupid. Like, I want to meet whoever thought, oh, hey, you know what, it's a good idea. Let's just make a dude fucking fall asleep all the time. What the hell is he doing now? Let's go. Like, I gotta fucking babysit this dumbass. Like, This is beyond the most annoying thing ever. Is he fucking... Oh my god, he's not coming! What the fuck? Yo, this mission is fucking the stupidest shit I've ever fucking experienced. This is literally the stupid fucking experience of my entire life. What are these harpies doing? Alright, these harpies aren't even fucking landing. I can't kill them. Fuck you, harpy. There's one down. Here's two. Fuck you. Come here, you stupid ass harpy. Come. Come the fuck on. Harpies! Man, fuck you, Harpy. I'll just fucking peg you with the crossbow. What is this Harpy doing? Fuck all you harpies. There we go. Now this dumb fuck is gonna fall asleep again. Here we go. You gonna fall asleep? Come on. Fall asleep. I know it's coming. Oh look, he hasn't fallen asleep yet. Let's go. God, this is the stupidest mission in any game I've ever played before in my entire life. Ever. Ever. There has not been a stupider mission in any game that I have played, all like 500 of them in my life, that's stupider than this mission. There isn't any one. There's not one. I can't think of it. There's not one dumber than this one.
I don't want to go to school.
Shut the fuck up and get your ass up. Let's go, dumbass. Are we going, or are you just gonna fucking take it?
What has it brought you to this strange place?
Looking for someone.
Here?
Mm-hmm.
Shut the fuck up and keep your ass awake.
Not too keen on talking about it, are you?
Not really.
Oh my god, are you actually gonna fall asleep again, you dumb motherfucker? Get up here. Get your shit up here, you stupid fucker.
Just be sure and come back. And make it quick, eh? Not that much to see here.
Thank God I fucking brought that stupid piece of shit back here. God, that was so stupid. I don't think I've ever gotten that mad over a damn mission either. Like, I don't even... That's just frustrating as all fuck. I don't really care. But that mission is just stupid. Like who is... Who sat down and is like, oh, yeah, let's just make a guy who... Why am I even fighting these guys? I don't even have to. Ah, hey, Fiend. How's it going?
The Fiend. Stubby legs, too slow.
What are you Fiend doing? Just letting me wail on it? I killed the Fiend just like that? You're pathetic.
One of the missing dwarves. Shame he's dead.
Thank God you're dead. I don't have to do shit with you. Alright, let's go! I'm just gonna run by your ass. Okay. Let's go. Let's return to this stupid-ass hut. put my weapon away. And is this thing actually still following me? Alright. The stupidest mission in the world.
Are you your friend?
Fucking done with it, thank God.
Let's hear him then.
Wake up.
I'm awake.
Gaspard, stand back. I'm opening the door.
Gaspard, you seem a bit muddled.
Muddled. A bit drowsy, that's all.
What of the others?
Found one near a monster's den. He was already dead, sadly. Saw another fall from a cliff. Broke his neck.
Shit. Ravenick told me to have an eye on the snot. T'was his nephew. Thanks for helping, and sorry I didn't trust you.
Oh, everything's gone wrong. What'll we do now?
Got a boat. You can leave with me, but I need to find someone first.
An ashen-haired lass?
Yes.
Oh, dreadful sorry.
Step aside.
She's cold. Spirits left her. Nothing we could do.
Let's wait by the boat.
Guess not all of Vesemir's teachings have receded into oblivion.
A Witcher can forget to eat, to drink, to breathe even. But a Witcher never, ever forgets to care for his blade.
Yeah, I used to repeat that incessantly. Never tired of doing it either.
What creature was it?
Huh? Creature?
One that gave you the scar over your left eye. It's new. I don't remember it.
Souvenir from the Cockatrice of Spala. Another addition to the collection. Nothing special. Yours has healed beautifully, though.
Avalok. He prepared some special ointments for me. But that was before the curse gripped him. Wonder where he is now.
We lifted the curse. He's at Kaer Morhen, waiting for you.
Are you serious? You must be. You'd not jest about something like that. A nice thing to wake up to.
You trust him?
Avalok? He's not let me down to date. Not once.
Why exactly is Avalok helping you? Sages have never been fond of humans.
He doesn't do it for me. It's about my power. As if it could ever be about anything else. Avalok tried to teach me how to control my ability. He was also making sure I didn't fall into Eridan's hands.
How do you ever start traveling with Avalok?
As soon as I had left you and Yen on the Isle of Avalon, I found myself pursued. Eridan and his Red Riders were on my heels. I fled through many worlds, many times. They came very close to catching me once. It was then that Avalok appeared, out of nowhere. He found a portal and took us to a world where Eridan couldn't find us for, oh, perhaps half a year.
So why'd you return?
I thought the Hunt had lost my scent for good. I thought I was safe. Besides, I wanted to find you. You and Yennefer.
You were looking for us. We were looking for you. Times I thought you were just a step away. Other times, felt like I was going around in circles.
I'm not surprised. There were times I fled pell-mell headfirst and forward.
So tell me how it happened, step by step.
Eridan located us mere moments after we landed on Ard Skellig. Soon after, he and his riders surrounded us. I thought it was over, the end. Turned out Eridan had other plans. He produced the phylactery, uncorked it. A fog enveloped us, and Avalok began gasping for air.
That's how Eridan cursed Avalok, triggered his transformation into Uma?
Yes. He didn't wish to kill him. Humiliation, that's what he was after. But Avalok refused to succumb without a fight. He cast a spell that wrought havoc in the Hunt's ranks.
And in a full half of a forest on Ard Skellig.
Yet it also gave us time to flee. Avalok opened a portal. I leapt in. He was supposed to follow right behind me, but something went awry. Impaired by the curse, he failed to reach the portal in time. We had agreed that if anything went wrong and we were separated, we would meet at his hideout in Venon.
But you failed to meet there.
Yes, we failed to. Once through the portal, instead of at Avalok's hideout, I landed right in the middle of Crookback Bog. I barely escaped the crones. And then there was the Baron. You know, he took me hunting. I killed a wild boar with my sword.
I heard.
A coincidence, really. I had no desire to hunt that day, but it felt wrong to refuse. I'd taken nothing remotely resembling a hunting weapon. I simply hadn't intended to hunt. I was wandering through the forest, breathing deep the air. And then I heard a strange sound. Unsettling.
Boar attacked you?
Mm-hmm. Big as a bison, and lumbering straight at me. And all I had was my sword. Had to manage.
Did just fine, judging by how the Baron's men remember it.
Simple soldiers, the whole lot. But we got along splendidly. A shame I had to leave. Flee. But I didn't want to bring the Wild Hunt down on them. Apart from which, I knew by then the curse was progressing. So instead of looking for Avalok, I decided to find you and Yen.
So how do you even meet a man like Horson Jr.?
You and Yennefer were nowhere to be found. And I needed someone who could fix the phylactery. No ordinary craftsman would do. I needed a mage. One with extraordinary powers. Dandelion took it upon himself to help me. It was as if his honor depended on it. He arranged a meeting with a mage, but it proved a trap set by the temple guard.
Failed to mention that.
Probably didn't want to worry you. Later, we learned the guard did that sort of thing regularly. In the hope of nabbing anyone who collaborated with mages. We needed to find another way. That was clear. Then Dandelion said he knew a man who owned a piece of Novigrad, as he put it, could do more than others. He was certain to know someone who could fix the phylactery.
Orson Jr.
Mm-hmm. I suspected it might not be the best idea, but I was desperate. I had no choice.
You suspected right. Orson was not the ideal partner in crime.
Damned simpleton got it in his head that we'd cheated him and kidnapped Dudu.
Who you promptly freed only to have to flee to Temple Isle. Great idea.
We hadn't planned it. Had no time to consider. We'd just bolted. I didn't even realize the guardsmen were driving me into a trap. Suddenly there I was, and I knew I had to disappear. At once.
And that's when you landed back in Skellige.
The shore of Hindisfjall. The first pleasant place that came to mind. Hjalmar and I used to swim there.
Wait, so you actually wound up there by accident? I thought you and Avalok had arranged something.
No, he simply sensed me use my power. Just as Eredin can sense where I am, where I travel. In fact, Eredin arrived soon after I did. His riders in tow. Once again, things happened quickly. Lofoten, the Hunt's attack, my flight. And then, dreams. Just dreams.
What did you dream? I've had nothing but nightmares lately. Pretty horrible.
Likewise, for the most part. In one, a monster grown from a stillborn child chased you. Ugh, that was horrible. Had a few nice dreams. For example, in one we sat around a fire, drinking good wine, and all around people danced and laughed.
I like that one a lot better.
Me too. But these dreams, and the others, ended in some tower. No matter what I'd dream, in the end, I would enter a tower.
Recognize it? Know where it might be?
Not sure. I don't think so, but there was something familiar about it. And something terrifying. The tower was stark and dead. But at the same time, I felt I had to enter it.
Did you?
No. Dreams all ended with me searching for the entrance. And the last time, instead of the tower, I saw your grizzled face. If not for the scar over your eye, I'd have thought I was still dreaming.
I was afraid you were dead. Found some dwarves here. Said they'd try to wake you, but you were cold as ice and you weren't breathing.
And yet you came in.
Who listens to dwarves these days? Speaking of which, they're probably getting antsy. We should go. Got a boat on the beach. Once we land, we'll head for Kaer Morhen. On horseback.
Right. Conventional means of travel. They're just better. Though a portal would be quicker.
And draw Eredin to us immediately. Rather not risk it. Besides, I hate portals. Damn!
Wait, those motherfuckers sold my boat? I knew I hated fucking
Listen,
dwarves.
We gotta think of a way to.
Here they come.
Get us out of here.
They'll know where we've gone. They'll know how to find me.
They already do. Ciri, take us home.
Oh, shit. Something more. Find Ciri. Alright, I'm gonna cut the episode here. We'll be back right.